Says, I thought it was insanely irresponsible on the part of both the Wired journalist Andy Greenberg and the hackers to do the car hack demonstration on a public highway. Anyone with any sort of common sense would do this test on a private road or racetrack, but not a highway. The sheer stupidity of this is mind-boggling. Quite frankly, if they endanger themselves through their childish decisions and behavior, that's their problem, but endangering others because of your sheer stupidity is another kettle of fish. I went to Twitter because I'd seen a lot of people say this in reaction. There's even a video of Greenberg driving the car and showing what happens. He doesn't come close to an accident. There is a semi coming up behind him, but the semi sees that he's slowing down. But a lot of people say it doesn't matter. He could have, that could have endangered someone. Someone might have not been able to tell that he was slowing down. I don't know that he ever went below the legal minimum for the interstate, but nobody seems to be defending this. I haven't even seen Wired react to it, although I may have missed it. Do you guys agree with Juice, or do you, you know, I think I could make an argument for why this wasn't an issue, but I kind of think it was irresponsible as well.
I think it's entirely irresponsible. I don't know why they couldn't do it in some other way. I maybe am not as, you know, upset about it because, I don't know, maybe I'm less upset about things that went okay and now we have some interesting data, but going into it, I don't know why they didn't do that in the first place. Maybe it was to just demonstrate more clearly how dangerous this is by doing it in a live situation.
Yeah, but to show it's like, this is for real. Like, sure. This is what could happen to you.
And that's where I would defend it, is that if this is done on a racetrack, if this is done on a private road, it's a tech news story. This, and I don't know how much it's really broken outside of our sphere, but if, like, this is the kind of stuff, I mean, we saw what happened, was it, you know, 12 years ago with the Firestone tires on the SUVs and how that became a big, gigantic national story because they caused rollovers. This is more important than that. And if the point is this is insanely dangerous and we don't want to see this end in a fatality because it gets out and some irresponsible hacker wants to, you know, do something that is he or she doesn't really understand and really hurt somebody, then the way to like you said, Tom, make a big clarion call to, like, stop connecting some of these systems only happens when a big ugly truth confronts us.
What's the difference between that ugly truth and reckless endangerment, though? Like, there
I'm waiting for a Wired explanation, because the defense that I could see is that they would say, like, nothing was going to happen that couldn't happen anyway to a car under normal operating conditions. Sometimes engines die and people have to coast to the side of the road, and that is what they were doing. The other thing is, you see this in the video, but I don't know if it was made perfectly clear in the article, unless you read it all the way through. The fix to the transmission being killed was to restart the car. As soon as you restart the car, you gain control of the transmission again. And you hear in the video the two security researchers saying, restart the car, we told you not to panic. And if that's the case, I could see them rationalizing it, saying, we will always really be in control of the car. Sure, the transmission will be cut, but that's no different than some kind of normal thing where you just have to slow down. That is not reckless endangerment, slowing down on a highway. As long as we restart the car and gain control and maintain a legal speed, then we're not breaking any laws. And I could see that being their defense.
Mm, yeah, would it be interesting to hear them actually do that? And I don't know what the likelihood of it is. I guess it depends on the heat that comes from this, but I don't know. I'm torn because Justin's right. This is a better, it's over with. Now here's the data demonstration. This is a more powerful one because of what.
Well, and like, yes, is it reckless? Is it stupid? Sure, probably. You can make a really compelling argument. But is this a problem that is just sitting there waiting to be a bigger, uglier, possibly deadly problem in the future? Yeah, and demonstrating it on an open highway and not a controlled setting like a racetrack or a private road, I think, is a more powerful demonstration that this doesn't need perfect conditions.
All right, that is it for this episode of the Daily Tech News Show. Thank you, Justin, Robert, Young.